सो गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। के लास्ट लेक्चर वी ऑल हैड डिस्कस अबाउट द फ्रॉग। नाउ सी वी व्हेन वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट द फ्रॉग वी हैड डेल्ट विद द प्रॉब्लम दैट चलो अभी टू पार्टी पार्टीशंस आर बीन डन हियर, ऑरिकल्स आर सेपरेटेड, सो एनी हाउ द टू वे और डबल सर्कुलेशन इज बीन सेट अप, बट द This double circulation was imperfect. Imperfect, that means here somewhere into the ventricle mixing of the blood was there. The reason behind that was that the right auricle as well as the left auricle both were just shunting, or you can say was driving their blood inside the ventricle. Up here mixing is happening, so somewhat mixed blood is only going to the lungs for the oxygenation, and some way the mixed blood is only entering inside the systemic circulation. But with the now see, this was the new setup. Till now the animal was inside the water, right? So they were well equipped with the gills, and the gills were very efficient in doing the systemic circulation, or you can say to send or to push the blood inside the systemic circulation. But now the respiratory mechanism is totally changed. The lungs have overtaken to the gills. Now the lungs do not have the efficiency of doing this type of circulation. Means they were like gills, as gills were able to send the blood to the systemic circulation, the lungs were limited there, they were not able to do the same. So at that particular stage, the idea was there that this particular task been given to the heart, as I had given you example into the previous lecture. So now the heart have responsibility to take care of the systemic circulation as well as the pulmonary circulation. So this mixing of the blood was keeping the organism to the low metabolic rate, because see, the somewhat mixed blood is only coming. So the concentration of the oxygen was quite low inside the body. But if the organism, those who are completely on your, you can say, land, if they have to perform the high metabolic activities, so at that time will this mixed blood will not help them to come out and to be on land. So for adapting the terrestrial ecosystem, the organism, they need to do some changes into the heart, okay, because now respiratory system has been modified. It is you can say well sophisticated or well suited for the terrestrial environment. So now there must be changes into the heart pattern. So there was an idea to avoid certain type or such type of mixing. There is a need that this ventricle should be partitioned, because here mixing is occurring inside the ventricle. So for this purpose, the ventricle is been septated, but this septa is just bringing up. Now see, heart is still three chamber only with evolution, but it is just been septated. Septated means it is partially partitioned by having a septum, or you can say a device, a membrane, which is temporarily being avoiding the mixing, but still the mixing is happening, not that extent. Now you imagine about the organism, those who have to work in the dwell situation, means for long period of the time they have to hold the breath, say example the crocodile. So this particular type of circulation will not work out here. So there are more modification in detail we all are going to discuss today about the crocodilian heart. But till now you just understand with evolution what changes are happening. Three chambered heart you have already studied in detail. Now see, those who were not there in the previous lecture, they must watch it, because it is very important to understand the system, how the heart from is modifying from the two chamber to the three chamber, and three chamber to three chamber separate, separated or septated. Now these three chambers separated heart has brought the good quality of the blood. Now this blood is more and more oxygenated, because see here what is happening, the partition, it is preventing the partial mixing, but still more or less a small partitioned part or small portion is mixing only. So here partial mixing of the blood is there, but this particular circulation will not work out into the crocodile. As I told you that they have to dive for the longer period of time. So for diving, their ventricles are properly well separated. Actually, see student, this way evolution is happening. First, into the evolution, the ancestor are the fishes, and then from the fish, amphibians are evolved. From the amphibian, another class that are turtle, lizard, snake, they all have evolved, as well as the crocodile also evolved from the same time, from the tetrapod. Amphibians only they have been evolved, but the thing was, the crocodile, immediately after the crocodile, which group has emerged? Archaeopteryx. We are going to learn in details about the evolution. That time these things will be more and more clear. But student, limitation is we all are going to learn that into the fourth semester. So, abhi filhal itna evolution samajhne ki koshish karenge. Ke till now, the crocodile is there, and from the crocodile, a new class has been evolved that are known as Archaeopteryx, who abhi ke zamane mein extinct hai. So there were connecting link between the reptiles as well as the bird. So unme aadhi qualities birds ki thi, aadhi jo hai reptiles ki thi. So this is a very big proof of the evolution. Evolution ke time mein isme detail mein baat karenge, but for time being, we all are not going to touch the Archaeopteryx at all. So now here, what is happening? Fish में तो लंबा चौड़ा circulation है. We all have seen के जो है body से blood will go to the heart and heart से gills में, फिर gills में भी रहेगा. But still यहाँ पर एक plus point है कि nowhere the blood is mixing. Okay. But efficiency of gills is supporting this particular system. But now system has been advanced. Okay. So now here heart has been partitioned, but यहाँ पर extra extra chambers लगा के जो है काम चलाया जा रहा है कि चलो extra chambers are there, so this extra chamber were supporting. We all have seen the sinus venosus and conus arteriosus, or you can say the truncus arteriosus, they were helping to or you can say these were the accessory chambers, those who were supporting the heart so that the heart can work in an efficient way and maximum way the heart can prevent such type of mixing. But still proper heart mein hi system nahi tha, then bit partitioning is evolved in the case of the turtles and lizard, snake. At that particular time the lungs se jo whatever blood is coming to the heart, it is having more and more concentration of the oxygen. Now this way the lizard, turtles and snake, they become more efficient, and still the metabolic rate is very very much high in the case of the crocodile. And another thing is that the crocodile wants to dive into the water. Abhi, for what purpose they are going to dive inside the water? They all are not like amphibian ke reproduction ke liye, and they are having the external type of fertilization. For that reason they all are going there. Crocodiles, they are going inside the water for their food. Okay, so when they are going inside the water, they are diving, so they have to hold the breath for the longer period of time. Lekin ab yahan par evolution se limitations kahan par aa rahi hai? They don't have any gills, they have the lungs, and they have to hold the breath. So when they are holding and they have to be inside the water for the longer period of the time, so for that purpose there must be some specialized modification inside the heart so that their diving can sustain for the longer period of time and their body can act on that particular time. So what way out they have found? Heart mein partitioning properly kar diye, but whatever vessels were there na, they brought the modification into the vessel and foramen of Panizza, a small connecting link which are connecting the oxygenated vein as well as the deoxygenated vein, or you can say the aorta, the thick blood vessels, connection has been made So that when they are going inside the water, so at the time of the diving, they can sustain their body on the mixed type of blood. So how this is happening in detail, we all are going to learn. Now I will not talk about birds and mammal heart because this is more advanced version which we all are going to discuss into the next class. Okay, now let us start about the crocodile heart. So when we talk about the crocodile heart, this is also present midventrally. Now, see in your textbook, the position of the heart is not mentioned. So write down that crocodile heart is present midventrally. Okay. So now when we talk about the number of chamber, as I told you that there was a need of the more oxygenated blood. So to increase the concentration of the oxygen into the blood, the heart is properly four chamber. But this type of MCQ can be asked, except dash, all the reptiles have the three chamber heart. So you should remember, crocodile are the only example into the reptilian class, those who all have the four chambered heart. Now the four chamber hearts are there. So do you think, is there any need of the accessory chambers? Yes. Come on, student, please reply quickly. They have the properly four chamber heart. So what is your opinion about the accessory chambers? It will be there or not? Yes, fast. Say yes or no. Will they have the accessory chamber? Come on, fast. They do not possess any accessory chambers. Now, this accessory chamber with evolution absorbed inside the heart, like you can see the sinus venosus, it was absorbed inside the right aorta because we all have seen के वो जो है right aorta के ही लिए काम कर sorry right atrium के लिए ही काम कर रहा था. It was helping the collection of the blood, right? So now here this atrium, it become very well efficient itself. It is going to collect all the blood from all part of the body. Now here no need of such accessory chambers. Okay, now when we talk about crocodilian heart, anatomically it will also have the pericardium. Can anyone tell me the name of the two pericardiums? Yes, students, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so please tell me the name of two pericardium and the role of pericardium also. What
Sinus
is the
venosus.
no, accessory chamber? I'm not asking accessory chamber. Pericardium, remember this is two layered, in between fluid is there. Come on, now I have given hint. Come on, tell me the name of the two pericardium. What is pericardium and what is the role of it? Please repeat again. Yes.
Pericardium, visceral pericardium,
Very good. Visceral pericardium and
parietal,
excellent. Who is this?
annum.
Very good, Anam. Now see, there are two pericardium. Now other than Anam, anyone should tell me the name, purpose or function of the pericardium. What is the role of the pericardium, children? Yes. What is the role of pericardium? You have told the very correct name. Come on, fast. What is the role? Why this pericardium is present? Fast.
It acts as barrier.
What?
It acts as barrier against extension.
Yes, correct. What other role? So students, we all can say it is a protective layer. It is a protective layer which protects the heart.
Mechanical protection.
Yes, it gives the mechanical protection to the heart. Now see, same like other organism which we have discussed earlier, this crocodilian heart is also supported or protected inside the pericardium. And this pericardium is two-layered, like we have discussed into the frog, visceral and the parietal. And exactly like that, the pericardial fluid is also present. And this fluid is preventing the heart from the shock and you can say friction and all. Now, this is about the external or the position of the heart. Now, I told you that heart is divided in proper four chamber. Atrium pura yahan tak ke hai, bachcho. This right atrium is this much big, okay? Now, atrium. So, when we talk about the right atrium is bigger, as we have discussed in the earlier case. So, with evolution, in frog only, atrium was separated properly, right? So now here we are going ahead of the evolution, the atrium ke mixing ka ya fir kuch bhi aisa chance possible hi nahi hai. Now here this septum is completed now. Okay, ab with evolution kya hone wala hai malum hai, aage ke case mein aap dekhoge ki this septum will be converted into the proper wall like structure, muscular banne wala hai. But now till here this septum was there, so septum has been increased. Pura till end tak ke septum rahega, ventricle is completely divided. Okay, now here when we talk about, chalo one by one we will talk about all the four chamber. When we talk about the right atrium, so as I told you, right atrium is bigger as compared to the left atrium. In diagram also you can conclude about it. And this is having three openings of the vena cava. Now when we talk about separation, so like frog, here also the right atrium and left atrium, they will be separated by a thin wall, interauricular septum. Interauricular septum. Now when we talk about the sinus venosus, so it is not at all present. Up sinus venosus is not present. Who is collecting blood from the body? Now see, who's the collecting, main collecting chamber blood from the body is the right atrium. So now that job has to be done by the right atrium itself. For that reason, the sinus venosus has been absorbed. Now when we talk about the left atrium, so left atrium will collect the blood from the lungs. So you can see the pulmonary vein opening is here and it is smaller as compared to the right auricle. Now when we talk about the ventricles, so we know about ventricle till now that it is a distributing chamber and it must be, as it has to distribute blood to the longer distance. So definitely it must be very much stout and it should be thick walled. So this, the modification in this type of heart is that this ventricles, they are separated completely by interventricular septum. Now this septum is bit oblique. If you will observe into the diagram only, you can see that it is bit oblique. Now when, if any septum is placed oblique, what is happening? It is going to give two unequal half. So for that particular reason, you will observe left ventricle is bit smaller as compared to the right ventricle. Now see, this septum is this septum is called as the auriculoventricular septum, or sorry, auriculoventricular and only ventricular septum. Now connection, of course the right atrium and right ventricle should be connected, same way the left atrium and left ventricle should be connected. So you know, we have discussed about the aperture. So yes, the connection between two chambers always bring about the aperture. So here also apertures are required. So when we talk about the right atrium have the opening into the right ventricle, via the right auriculoventricular aperture, and this will have the valve. Valve ka naam bhi same hai bachcho, that is right auriculoventricular valve. When we talk about the left auricular ventricular aperture, so this is connecting the left atrium and the left ventricle, and they will be having the left auriculoventricular valve. Now when we talk about the ventricle, so we all know that this wall is quite muscular and there are tendinae. So here also, in the previous example, we all have discussed about the musculature which are protruding inside the heart. So here also that chordae tendinae are attached to the wall of the ventricle, and these all are holding the walls and they shut them to prevent the backflow of the blood into the auricle. Now when ventricle will contract, so lots of pressure is going to exert it, because now here the body of the animal is big. So that particular reason these walls are very much stout, and now this wall will not at all let a single drop of the blood to go back. Now when we talk about where these ventricles are going, so these ventricles, just a minute, a student, give me 1 minute. Student, sorry for the inconvenience. So, sorry for disturbance. Okay, students, right atrium. Once again, we will revise the complete anatomy. We have seen there are four chambers: right atrium, left atrium, right ventricle, left ventricle. So now this right atrium has absorbed the sinus venosus. No accessory chamber are present. Now this sinus venosus used to collect blood. So whatever veins and whatever ducts were there, it was present on the sinus venosus. But now here, this chop is been directly taken by the main chamber, that is the right atrium. So this right atrium will have the three vena cava opening. Now when we talk about the left atrium, so left atrium to bechara khud hi apna kaam kar raha tha, it was not having any supplementary accessory chamber. So here left atrium, we all know it is collecting the blood from the lungs. So here also it is doing the same job, pulmonary veins are present. Now when we talk about the right ventricle, students, yahan par changes ventricles mein hai. So ventricles are very very important to remember, and ventricles mein bhi whatever ducts are coming na, these ducts are very 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 important. So now here when we talk about the left ventricle, so we all have just discussed that whatever blood is coming, it is coming from the auriculoventricular aperture, and there are walls which are guarding. Now we will talk about the ventricle. So left aortic arch, it is, now see again I am telling left aortic arch, that you need to remember, it is coming from the right wala diagram mein dekhte hain. This left aortic arch, it is coming from the right side of the ventricle. Okay, right side ventricle is giving out this. Okay, now here how the blood is coming, what is happening, that we all will discuss. Blood is coming in detail we will be discussing when we will be talking about the working of the heart, but for now there is one accessory arch which is known as foramen of Panizza. Now see what is happening, student. Blood is collected by the right auricle that will be shunted inside to the right ventricle, and this blood has to go to the pulmonary circulation, right? But this blood sometimes do not taken to the pulmonary circulation, but instead of that it is going to taken inside the body by the why it is taken inside the body only, the reason behind when the this animal, or you can say the crocodile, it goes inside the who's calling me again and again, when this animal goes inside the water, it do not breathe. So that particular situation, the lung should not, nostril should not open, so the blood should not go to the lungs, because as there is no particular blood is present or no particular oxygen is present inside the lungs. So for that particular reason, the blood will be prevented for entering inside the blood, and the blood will directly entering into the systemic circulation. This foramen of Panizza, this is supplementing the mixing of the blood at the time of the respiration inside the water. So for this note for today, we'll stop. We'll continue into the next lecture when we will be discussing about this physiology, or you can say the working of the heart. That particular time we will be discussing this point in detail. Now for time being, you all need to remember that three chambered heart, it is given. Now three chambered heart was not sufficient or efficient for the functioning of the animal like crocodile. It is such a big animal. So for that reason, the chance of mixing of blood was not possible. But still, diving brought the idea, whenever the animal is going deep inside the water, they need to be on the low metabolic rate. And that particular time, they wanted to prevent the opening of nostril, because it will take the water inside the lung, and they all are not the water animal or aquatic animal. So to avoid such harm to the body, they stop breathing. And that particular time, they wanted that mixed kind of the blood, or the blood which is deoxygenated should run into the circulation. So for that particular reason, they keep mixing of this blood by the specialized part into their vessels, that is known as the foramen of Panizza. So how all this happening is a big question in our mind, but that will be discussed into the next class. Any doubt till here in anatomy? Yes? Any doubt, students? If not, we can stop for now. Yes, students, come on fast.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Anything you want me to repeat again and explain you the again?
No, ma'am.
Okay. I'm not audible.